Show.
With the Steel Drivers, you had recorded If It Hadn't Been for Love, this one, if you remember this.
Oh, yeah.
You do?
Never would have hitchhiked to Birmingham if it hadn't been for love.
Well,
never would have called.
This song, the way it goes, Adele was on tour. Her bus driver's playing this. Listen to it. She hears it, and she says, hey, what is that song? And then she records it.
That's the story I know. That's all I know about it, though.
Had you ever met her?
No, never met her.
Does she just contact your publishing company and say, hey, I'm going to put this on my record?
I don't know if that even happened. At first, it was like a YouTube video or something. She did like a, you know, just a YouTube something of it. And Ken Irwin, the guy that owned Rounder Records that the Steel Drivers were on at the time, sent me an email. And this was before Adele was Adele, almost,
right.
You know. She had had 19, which had had, you know, she got New Artist of the Year at the Grammys or something. But it wasn't like
right.
She was Adele.
Right.
You know? And so I remember he sent me an email. And he's like, hey, Adele is doing this song on YouTube. You should really try to get your publishing company to kind of push her to put it on a record or something. I was like, well, that's great, Ken. Who's Adele?
Yeah, right.
That was literally my email back, and it was probably the funny. I think about that now, and it was really.
And meanwhile, it ended up on that album that sold 10 billion copies, and you get paid for that, which is
so
cool.
Yeah, well, it was on the like the UK European versions of 21,
I see. So cool when somebody does your song like this is her version, different key, right?
Yes.
Never would have hitchhiked to Birmingham if it hadn't been for love. Never would have caught the train to Louisiana if it hadn't been for love. Never would have run through.
Are you happy with her version?
Oh yeah, thrilled. I love her as a singer and as an artist generally. So
when you hear that, are you kind of judging her too? Like, hey, what did she do with my song?
No, I feel like that. And you, back to the songwriting point, I always kind of like to write the songs and they get turned loose into the world and who knows what happens with them. That's the artistry thing, and that's the kind of the joy of being a songwriter is getting to hear what other people do interpretation-wise.
The Howard Stern Show.